What is going on, guys? Welcome back to another fresh video of Android application development in Android Studio. In this video, we are going to see how we can develop our application with the help of HTML, CSS and JavaScript. You don't need to learn any language like Java or Kotlin to build an Android application. You just need to know basic HTML, CSS and JavaScript and you can make any application. So I will show you step by step in this video. So let's get started with new Android Studio project. Select empty activity and click on next. You can give your application name anything. I will give my web application and you can give your package name. And select minimum SDK Lollipop version so that 92.3% of devices can support the application. And then click on finish. So once your project is loaded, we have two main files over here. One is mainActivity.java and another is activityMain.xml. This is for layout designing and mainActivity.java is for coding. So first let's click on split over here and it will split the code and the preview of the application. So here is default hello world text. We need to remove that first. I will delete this. And I will convert this constant layout to linear layout. After that, I need to add one layout, that is a web view. For application to run the HTML, CSS and JavaScript, we need a web view. So let's add that. Layout width will be match parent and height also will be match parent so that it will occupy all the spaces of our application. And one more property I want to give, that is ID. You can give any ID. I have given web view. Now we will close this layout file and we will go to mainActivity.java. So inside onCreate method, we will create the reference of that web view first. Import this. Find view by ID. r.id.webview. So we have got the reference of that web view and now we will create HTML file. For that we will go to application here and right click new folder, assets folder. We will create an asset folder and once the assets folder is created, we will create HTML file over there. We will give the name index. So we have the HTML file and you can write your HTML code. So I have written a simple code and I have given the heading hello from HTML to test the application. Now we will load that index.html in the web view. For that we need to add webview.loadURL. We have the property loadURL and we should pass the path. For that we can get the Android asset from here, Android asset, and inside that we have index.html. So in this way web view will load this index.html and show it in our application. So let's run it to test either it is working or not. So yes, we can see that hello from HTML. So our HTML page is loaded successfully. We have that index.html file and it is loaded in our application successfully. So let's create one CSS file and test that also. For that, I will go to the same asset folder and create a CSS file. File style.css, and I will write some CSS code over here. I will give the body background. And I will also change the color of heading. So yes, I have just changed the background color to red and heading I have given white. So let's import that here. Style sheet, and we have file name styles. So we have successfully imported the CSS file, and let's run it and test it. So yes, our background color is changed and the heading color is also changed to white. So CSS is also working fine. HTML and CSS is done. Now we will go for JavaScript. For that, we will create a script file. And I will just print something. So I have written just hello from JavaScript for testing, and I will import that over here. And we need to add one more line in main activity to enable the JavaScript. So we will call one method. WebView dot get settings dot set JavaScript enabled, and we will pass true so that it will enable the JavaScript in our application. So let's run it now. So yes, our application is running successfully. We have got the message from HTML also, we have got from JavaScript also, and background color is red. It means we have CSS also. So in this way, you can make your own application with the help of simple HTML, CSS and JavaScript. So I hope you have learned something from this video. If you have liked this video, please hit the like button. If you have any doubts and queries, please comment down below. I will definitely reply for you, and also subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.